study from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at another knife from Mazarin out of Italy. And you may have seen some of my Mazarin reviews in the past. I think this is a company that does not get the attention that it actually deserves, because they have a lot of very nice high quality offerings at pretty competitive prices. For example, here the Pitbull that I have reviewed in the past here, pretty nice folder here, aluminum handles, M390 blade at a very competitive price point, ball bearing system, super smooth action, and just something that I think more people should know about. But now let's take a look at their new offering for 2018 that they debuted at SHOT Show as well as Blade Show of this year, and that is the Mazarin Nimrod. And it looks like this. It's a collaboration with the Italian designer Tommaso Rumici, who also did some collaboration work with Viper, Lion Steel, and some other Italian companies in the past. He also designed the Lion Steel Niala pen here, for example, that I also have. And he also designed the Viper Dawn, which is a very popular model in the Viper lineup. And now he collaborated with Mazarin on the Nimrod right here. The Nimrod is designed as a very nice, high-quality working knife. It reminds me a little bit of an upscale cold steel knife, because you have a nice, solid backlock design here with a pretty stout blade thickness here. But the steel is actually also M390, as you can see here on the blade, and you have a nice full-sized overall blade that you really can do some nice hard wood work with. And you also got some interesting handle material choice. You can see here their version of a tan micarta, which looks a little bit different than some other micartas you may know, like here for example on the Ace Biblio. You can see it's a more polished, a more G10 like micarta, but it certainly is micarta. You can see here the strands of the fabric on the inside, not as fabric-y as the one here on the Ace Biblio. And color-wise, it's more of a natural, some people call it. You can see here, for example, the micarta of the TRM Field Action. But you can see it's a little bit differently finished overall, so it's just something that I want you to know here. But it is certainly micarta. There are also different handle materials available. There is G10, there is actually also carbon fiber, and there is a green micarta as well. And you can see here the layers of the micarta, and then you have a stainless steel backlock system. Now let's take a look at the specs of this knife. So we have an overall length here of 8¾ inches or 22.2 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of 3.625 inches or 9.2 centimeters. We have an actual cutting length of 8.5 centimeters or 3.35 inches. The steel, as I said before, is M390 by Böhler, and we have a blade thickness of 3.3 millimeters, so certainly a quite stout blade thickness there. Then we have a handle length on this knife of 5⅛ inch or 13 centimeters, and a pretty skinny overall thickness of 1 centimeter or 0.4 inches. So very nice to carry this knife with you, coupled with the pretty light weight of the knife of this size here. This is certainly a great large knife in the pocket, just very unobtrusive, but still quite comfortable in the hand. Speaking of weight, let's check out that as well. Close it up for that. Hope you can see it. It's 125 grams or 4.4 ounces, and that for an overall length of nearly 9 inches and with a blade stock of over 3 millimeters. I think that is pretty amazing, that is that lightweight, really nicely done. And that is of course the case because you actually don't have full liners here. If I show you that here, you have only the micarta until right here, and then you have two partial liners on either side that go through the pivot point where you actually need the strength there. So very nicely engineered here to just use some partial liners on this knife. Very nicely done there, and that certainly keeps the weight down at just 4.4 ounces for this pretty large folder, and that is something that I really appreciate, especially coupled together with the nice and slim carry in the pocket here on the Nimrod. So very well designed by Tommaso Rumici. And you can see also the backlock also does its job pretty solidly. No up and down, no side to side play here. Very, very solid lockup on this knife. And of course, because it's a back lock, you won't have a lot of flickability here, because there is a little bit of a strong pressure on the back lock just to keep it nice and strong when it's opened. But it's mostly a just solid roll open opening that you will do with your Nimrod. With a little bit of wrist action, you actually could do spidey flick like I've done here, or maybe even a thumb flick, but that is a little bit harder just because you have a lot of tension on the back spring here. Centering is also done pretty nicely, not 100%, a little bit to the left side right here, but I'm probably able to fix that with the pivot point right there. Had absolutely no problem with that, doesn't touch the liner or anything, and still has a very rock solid lockup. But just something to note here on my particular version, it's slightly off to the left side. Another great thing about this knife is the pocket clip. You can see you have a nice deep carry, really deep carry pocket clip, and you have this flat end here on the back. That means that you can swap it for tip up carry left or right side, and you actually also can swap it for a glass breaker tip that looks like this, and you're getting the tool for doing that with it as well. So pretty nicely done here to give us these two different options. One thing that I would like to see is a tungsten carbide insert into the glass breaker, so you could use it for multiple windows, because I think this tip here could bend on some really hard glass. But I actually don't know what kind of steel this little glass breaker is made out of, so maybe it's more stable than I think. Another thing that you notice here is the lanyard hole in the back, which is placed at a little bit of an odd place, but they probably had to do that so it wouldn't interfere with the pocket clip here, and it's also a little bit small for the size of the knife. I would like to see an integrated lanyard hole into the back spacer somehow, or just leave it out, because on a knife of this size, I think a lot of people won't actually use a lanyard, but they chose to do it like this, and it's actually also hidden in the steel backspacer, so there is no possibility to cut your lanyard off with your blade. Ergonomically, it's pretty impressive here. With its thinness, it still feels very, very hand-filling. Nice chamfers on the micarta handles, you can see that all around here, really well done here on the micarta sculpting. They could have done a little bit more of a rounding to the scales to give it even a more hand-filling feel, but then you would lose the slimness in the pocket, and it's very, very comfortable to use it like this for multiple hours on end. And they also have some nice jimping here at the top of the blade spine, as well as on the back lock, and the back lock also works really well. And it's just a back lock, it's not a triad lock. You can see that here is just the arm of the back lock that engages the blade, and very nice and flush when it's engaged. Another thing that I noticed is that there are slight gaps between the scales and the back spring mechanism right here where you depress the back lock, but other than that, the fit and finish here is done really well. But you can see here there is a little bit of a gap at that portion of the handle. The pocket clip works actually quite well. Very nice and strong pocket clip, but easy to get in and out of the pocket, just because it is not the most grippy micarta. There is a little bit of grip provided, but it's not that grippy that it will shred your pockets when using the knife. The big star on this knife is of course the blade style and grind. It's a flat grind that starts very high up here on the blade. You have a nice stonewashed finish here, great drop point blade shape that is very versatile. Here you also have the model marking Nimrod, as well as the designer Tommaso Rumici on the blade, and here it states the steel as well as the company that makes this knife. And the M390 is just an amazing steel. It's probably one of the best steels out there all around for an EDC or work knife. Very, very good edge retention, great corrosion resistance, as well as pretty good toughness. And you can see this knife is just stupidly sharp. I now had it for a couple of weeks in my EDC rotation, also used it a little bit in the woods, carving some wood and things like that, just because it's such a large and burly knife, and it just performed absolutely perfectly and came razor sharp here from Mazarin. They really know how to sharpen and treat their M390 steel, and just a great blade design for multiple uses here. Very well done by Tommaso and his design crew. Nice and sharp and pretty thin behind the edge. You can see that here as well. It's very nicely done because it's nearly a full flat grind. You just have a little bit of flat portion here around the opening hole. Also, the opening hole is done very nicely. It's easy to get to here. Very nice and non-occluded, but still not too large to take away from the stability of the knife right here. And it just looks also very good in my opinion. I really think of a very high-end cold steel knife with the overall concept that they have done here on the Nimrod. I very much love that they chose micarta as a handle option because, you know, I'm a big fan of micarta. I like how it ages, how it looks, and how it changes over time. And it's just really, really comfortable. I have no hot spot here from the pocket clip, and you can see it's a very large handle. I have small to medium hands, and I have space for two other fingers here in the back. You also have a nice guard here in the front made by the handle itself. Nicely executed sharpening choil clears the plunge grind, so really well done there. Just overall some very nicely executed touches all over the knife here. You have a T8 pivot as well as T6 body screws. I think those could be a little bit larger on the overall scale of the knife right here. And maybe they could have rounded slightly more the insides of the scale. They are a little bit squared off there. But other than that, I'm very happy with the execution here of this knife. And it just feels so good to do some prolonged cutting with it. And you really feel like you have a very, very capable tool with you. And all that together with the amazing steel that I have chosen to use here on the Nimrod just makes this an absolute great high-end beater knife for some hard use tasks. Now let's do some size comparison. Something I forgot to mention before is that you have a very nice and smooth action when you just roll it open, and you can also shake it closed like this. So certainly a very nicely executed pivot point. I'm not quite sure if they actually use washers or it's just the polished surfaces of the inset steel liners. It's very tight in there in the pivot point, so it's pretty hard to take a look in there. But it certainly is a very nicely executed pivot point. You can see it's a very nice and refined overall action, especially for a backlock system. And of course, because it's a backlock, it's very, very safe. The blade is not going to fly out when you shake the blade. So pretty well done there. But now let's take a look at the overall size. Here we have the Nimrod at the top. And of course, the first comparison has to be the Mazarin Pitbull here. Also like the decorative pivot that Mazarin uses on a lot of their knives. And you can see here that the Nimrod at the top is a little bit smaller than the Pitbull, and I really like that they give you the option here of the flat-ended pocket clip screw, because I complained on this knife that this can actually be a little bit of a hazard and dig into your hand when you're just reaching by. So I like that this option is now present on the Nimrod. Here you had the same swappable clip, but you only had this type of glass breaker screw at the end. Of course, steel on both of these is M390, and here you have a little bit of a smoother action just because they use ball bearings and it's a flipper liner lock folder and not a back lock. But overall, also a very nice knife. I would like to see this style of screw hardware on the Nimrod just because they are a little bit larger and would fit the overall theme of this knife a little bit better in my opinion. Then the next comparison I have for you is a much less expensive knife but has a little bit of the overall vibe going on as well, and that is the CRKT Vaas. Looks like this. And size wise this is going to be quite a bit smaller. Also a hole opening knife like the Mazarin Nimrod here. Of course, materials, there is no comparison. Here also have a hollow grind, but both of them have a pretty nice and thin cutting edges. And performance-wise, just the cutting, they are pretty similar, but M390 will hold an edge much, much, much longer than the steel that is used here on the Vaas. But still a very nice folder, also nice deep carry clip with some countersunk screws. So that is also very nicely executed here on the Vaas. And the last comparison that I have for you is the Spyderco Spidey Chef, also an absolute favorite in my collection. Just a great, great overall knife. LC200N steel, also very nice, thin behind the edge. And size-wise, you can see that the Nimrod is quite a bit larger than the Spidey Chef as well. And the Spidey Chef is also quite a thin-handled knife, very easy to carry. And you can see the Nimrod is not much thicker. Very, very comparable in that respect. And both of them also have great clips. But this one is just a little bit more deep carry. You can also see the chamfering that is done here on the top of the knife. Just very nicely done, in my opinion. I really think the Nimrod is a great, great addition to the Mazarin lineup. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about the Mazarin Nimrod. And I'm very impressed with this knife, I have to say, after all. I think it's a very good overall design with some great materials, good choices in the handle material, and that is something that Mazarin does in a lot of their knives. There are always a lot of different versions of the same knife available, and they have some handle materials that you really don't see a lot from other companies, like for example this amazing, amazing green wood that they have here on this Atti model. And they also use some nice high quality steel on their knives. Here we have S35VN. On these two we have M390, which is arguably one of the absolute best steels for a folding knife out there. And here on this Nimrod, they have collaborated with a great Italian designer, Tommaso Rumici, who also has done some work with Lion Steel, Viper, and Fantoni, all Italian companies. And for the value that they provide here on the Nimrod, you have M390, you have Made in Italy, you have a micarta handle scale, and just overall great fit and finish and craftsmanship here on the Nimrod, also with the added feature of a removable glass breaker, and all that for under $200 with the M390 steel. I think this is certainly a great option, especially if you're searching for a larger work style or outdoor style folder, something that my good friend Kevin Cleary out of Canada might like, a larger EDC folder that can do some real work. So if you're interested in this knife or any other knives that I review on the channel, please check out my recommended retailer, White Mountain Knives. You will find a link to his eBay store as well as his website in the description below. And feel free to use my discount code, which is 7READY, for 10% off his whole website. This code will only work on his personal website. Just a great selection, good international shipping, and also just a nice guy to deal with, Justin there at White Mountain Knives. And certainly be sure to use that discount code to get a little bit of a break on your knife purchases. So this was my review of the Mazarin Nimrod. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun, and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.